Hi, welcome back to the MIGRO YouTube channel. My name's Shane, the founder of MIGRO. Today we're going to look at the little Ikea indoor grow light. It's called a Vaxar unit. And this is a 17 watts, 16 and a half watts from the wall unit, and covers a 60 centimeter by 30 centimeter grow area. So we've set it up, it's got its own little stand you get with it. We've just added some little rigs here so you can put it on our test mat. And we're going to take multiple measurements across the mat here. And this time I wanted to show you how I'm taking the readings and how I'm calculating then the average PPFD and then the PPFD for watt. The unit is set up for test now. Let's look at the power consumption. It's at 16 and a half watts. You can see the lead runs into the LED driver, the transformer from AC to DC, and up into the lighting unit. In each of these five elements, there is three LEDs, two whites and a red LED. And as I said before, in total, it covers really a 60 centimeter by 30 centimeter grow area. So we've divided this 30 by 60 centimeter grow area into 8 squares, and we're going to measure the PPFD level in each of those squares. So I've done up a little worksheet here, and on the worksheet you can see that we've marked out the 60 centimeter by 30 centimeter area. So the area is 0.18 meters squared. We've taken down the power, which is 16 and a half watts. And now we're going to take the PPFD in each of those squares, total it up, divided by 8, and get the average. So let's go. This is the readout of the SQ500, the PPFD meter. It's measured in tens of units. So the first square, we have a reading of 90. Forty, 140, 130, 60, 80, 160, 160, and 100. So let's work out the total of this. We're adding them all together and dividing them by the total amount. So that's 920 is the total amount, and we divide that by 8, the number of measures taken, and the PPFD average is 115. So the average of all those squares is 115. And now to get the total PPFD output, that's the average per square and over the area. So we multiply 115 by 0.18. And that equals 20.7 PPFD. And to get our efficiency, you divide the 20.7 by 16.5 watts, and that equals 1.25. So the efficiency of this unit is 1.25 micromoles per watt, which is pretty good. Next, look then at the spectrum. So I used the Asensetek passport. The unit we used to measure the spectrum and looked at the totals. So the amount of blue in the overall spectrum is 12%, which is pretty good for full spectrum. Sort of 12 to 15% is ideal, so it's just on the bottom limit. And then it's perfectly matched in terms of green and red. So both similar in terms of photosynthetic efficiency, so it's a perfect light for full spectrum growing. So not a bad light at all. You get an average, as I said, of 115 over 2 foot by 1 foot area, and an efficiency of 1.26 micromoles per watt, which is actually pretty good. So while we're checking out, I'm going to have a go at it and set it up and use it, and I'll let you know how I get on. Cheers, bye.